Welcome to Python series. This video is in continuation to my last Python video, which was about mutable and immutable data types. To understand the concept deeper, we are going to see the behavior of mutable and immutable data types inside a function. So to save the time, I have already written this program, and let us see step by step what this program is about and how it executes to give this output. So let us see the first line, which is just a print function. Okay, so inside the function, the first line is a print statement, and this backslash t is just for giving this tabbed space. Okay, so nothing important about it, you can remove it. It is just there to make the output look more clean and better to understand. Okay, so you all understand that whatever is inside this double quote and our thorny represents it as a green color, so it is just a text, it gets printed as it is. So you all understand this line. Second is again a print statement, but it also prints a variable a. Okay, so whatever is inside the variable a also gets printed together with this text. Okay, next we are adding a number to our variable. Okay, so we are adding a is equal to a plus 2. So whatever is there in a will get increased by 2. So that is also very simple to understand. Now this is again a simple print statement with a variable a again, and then a fully text based print statement. Okay, then we have a variable num which is defined as 3. So hope you all understand this. Next, again we have a print statement that contains a variable to be printed. Then we are calling the function and supplying it an argument. Next, again a print statement with a number. So let us see how this program executes. What happens when the program runs and it encounters this definition? It is going to ignore all these lines. Okay, so the first line to run is this num. So what happens? Num is created in the memory. Okay, and it stores the value 3. So this is your memory, and memory address is used here, and it saves the value 3. Second, this line gets printed. So calling my function by passing num value with value num. So this is you are seeing as the first output. Okay, calling my function by passing num with value. Now here you see instead of num you are seeing the number 3, because it is not inside this double quotation. So it is not a simple text, it is a variable. Which variable? This num, and what it contains? 3. So you are seeing 3 in the output. Then after this print statement, we are calling the function. Okay, my function 1 with the argument num. The num is 3. So the program goes to this now, and next there is a print statement with a tab. So this is what you are seeing inside my function. So it is just there to give in the output that you are inside the function now. Second statement, value received in a as. So value received in a as 3. Okay, so num is 3, we are supplying it as an argument, so it is 3. Next, a is equal to a plus 2. So what happens? Another memory address is created, which is a, and now a is a plus 2, which is 5, because a is 3 and 3 plus 2, 5. Next, we have the print statement. The value of a now changes to a. So now the a contains 5. Last statement, returning from my function. So you are returning to the main program. And after this line is executed, we are seeing the last print statement, which is here, back from my function, value of num is 3. So what we are originally trying to explain using this program, let's delete all this, what we supplied was number 3. Okay, so 3 went into the function right here. It was printed as 3, but after adding 2 to it, it becomes 5, and it really becomes 5, but only inside the function. Once the program returns to the main, this output is from the main program, not from the function. The function is only this much. This part is the main program. Okay, this part is from the main program. So the value is again 3. It is not 5 anymore. Why? Because the number integer is a immutable type, means there are no changes inside the memory address. If there is any need of change, a new memory address is created. So that was created inside the function. And if you remember from my mutable and immutable video, that immutable types do not get changed inside the memory address. Okay, and in mutable type, the changes are made in place. That means the memory address does not change, but the value inside the memory address changes. So in this case, the num being an integer and immutable type, it was defined in some memory address, whatever the number may be. So what happened when it went inside this function and it has to be changed? A new variable a was created, pointing to a new memory location. Okay, and the num retained its value 3. So when we asked for the value of num again using this last print statement, we see the number 3 again. Okay, so this was about immutable type. Let us use this very same program and give this program a mutable value. So let's delete all this and let's copy this whole program and paste it and give a mutable value. So we all know that list is a mutable type, data type. So let us supply a list here instead of number. So let's keep it very simple, 2, 3, a list containing 2 numbers. Okay, so the program remains as it is. We supply the number, then inside our program, let's add to the list. And because adding is slightly different in the case of list, we use the append function. You cannot just add a number to the list, you have to use the append function. So a dot append, and let's append some number, let's say 4. So our list will be 2, 3, 4, because we have added 4 now. So let's run the program and see what happens. let's understand by seeing the output. Calling my function by passing num with value 2, 3. So the program is running in the same way, and this being the first line, num, and obviously it contains 2, 3, which is we are seeing right here. Okay. Second, we are inside the function because the function is called now, and inside the function, you are inside the function, a is received as 2, 3. No issues. A is received as 2, 3. Second, we append 4 to our list, so the list changes to 2, 3, 4, which is printed using this line. Then we return from our function, and unlike our previous program where the value of 3 was again seen in the output, now we are seeing the changed list. It is same. If I scroll at the top, you will see we were seeing the old value 3, but now we are seeing the same value. Why? Because list is a mutable type, so the value was changed in place in the memory address. So visually, if you want to see, suppose this is your memory location containing the list. So in this case, because list is mutable, both these variables were pointing to the same memory address. So whatever change was done is reflected in both function as well as the main program. So this is the function, this is all function, and this is all inside the main program. Let us delete all this and try one more thing. Let's change our list. Instead of appending the list, let us make some changes in the list. So let us change this number 2 to say 4. So what is the index value of this number 2? It will be 0. If you remember, the index value start from 0. So number 2 is 0, number 3 is 1, and so on. So if we want to change the number 2, we will use its index value, which is 0. Okay. So A 0 is equal to, let's make it 4. So now the list has changed. It has become 4, 3. So let's run the program, and as you can see, the original value supplied was 2, 3. Then it is received as 2, 3. It changes to 4, 3 because we have changed the number 2 with 4, and we are seeing the change list because the list is immutable and the changes were done in the same memory address. So both the variables inside the function as well as in the main program were pointing to the same memory address, and since the change was done in place, you are seeing the same output. So hope you have understood the concept of mutable and immutable using this function program. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.